All right, good afternoon, true believers. This is John Krupa. This is the Freedom to Draw Unsolved Mysteries. Today's case is a missing girl. This is the missing, and this is a missing girl from Jersey City, New Jersey. And we usually do cases from Pennsylvania, but every once in a while we'll do some from other states. And this was requested by somebody that's into the show. So we're going to do it. Her name was Patricia Jane Wagner. There's not much information on her. We will tell you, to the best of my knowledge, about this woman who went missing in 1972 from Jersey City, New Jersey. Join me, guys. This is John Krupa as I exercise my freedom to draw unsolved mysteries. Join me in a couple seconds, guys. All right, today's case is a Patricia Jane Wagner. There's very few pictures of her online. She's been missing since 1972. We're going to draw her and tell you about her case. She is missing from Jersey City, New Jersey. Endangered missing is her classification. She is a female. She is white. And her date of birth was 7/19/1946. That would make her 77 years old to this day. She was 26 when she went missing. Height and weight was 5'3", 120 pounds. Distinguishing characteristics: Caucasian female, brown hair, blue eyes. Wagner's ears are pierced. And this is all off the Charlie Project. New Jersey State Police are the ones investigating this disappearance. Her details of the disappearance. Wagner was last seen in Jersey City, New Jersey on October 20th, 1972. She went out that day on a coffee date with a man who has only been publicly identified by his first name, which is Dennis. She never returned home after her date and has never been seen or heard from again. There was one kind of documentary slash podcast for about 4 minutes detailing Jane's case. She said that there's only two possibilities: that Dennis had something to do with this, her date, or a third party intervened and caused her disappearance and Dennis's disappearance, because they have never found this guy named Dennis either. Dennis also disappeared after his date with Wagner. She didn't take many personal belongings with her when she went on this date, and left behind her two small children. Dennis was never picked up his last paycheck. This led people to speculate he and Wagner had run away together. Dennis also disappeared after his date with Patricia. Wagner had and he had never picked up his last paycheck. This led people to speculate he and Wagner had run away together. Her family, however, believed foul play was involved. They said she wouldn't have abandoned her children, and Dennis had a reputation for violence. I believe also on that podcast, it was only about 4 minutes long, but she said that she had recently broken up with an ex, and he had a tendency to abuse her also. Now that could be the possible third party there that intervened and did something to both of them. There's a possibility of the ex running into them on purpose, or maybe by accident, and just, you know, forgive the term, but going postal, just losing it, you know, and doing something terrible to the both of them. There's that possibility too. Dennis's whereabouts were unknown for decades after Wagner's disappearance, but in 2020 he was located live and well in Florida, but he refused to discuss Wagner's disappearance with her family. At the time of Wagner's disappearance, she was a stay-at-home mother who occasionally earned money doing housekeeping. Her case remains unsolved. Now, that sighting in Florida, according to the podcast I listened to, was unconfirmed. Some people said that it was him, some people say it wasn't him. There is nothing concrete that's saying that that actually was the guy that she was out on a coffee date with. It's interesting to note that one of her kids was adamant her not going on this coffee date. And he was insistent upon it, where she had to actually say something to console him. He did not want her to go. And she had to promise him a trip to McDonald's the next day just to console him so he wouldn't be upset. I don't know, some people just get those feelings, you know, that something terrible is going to happen. They get like premonitions. It does happen. I've seen it happen. And it's unexplained how it happens. So this article is from October 16th, 2020. Cousin, a New Jersey woman who vanished in 1972, refuses to give up hope. Ellen Mahalico was born a month after her cousin, Patricia Jane Wagner. She vanished after leaving her New Jersey home to go on a coffee date. But Eileen told investigators she has always felt a strong connection to the family member, affectionately known as Patty. That prompted her to devote her life to searching for Patty and others. "We just missed each other by a month," Eileen said, "but I feel like she's always been in my life, and since she doesn't have a voice, I feel like I need to give her one." Patty was a 26-year-old single mother of two boys when she disappeared on October 20th, 1972. They lived in a two-family home in Jersey City, New Jersey, with Patty's mother, Marie. Now, she had asked her mother to watch the kids so she could go out on this date. And she did. That evening, Patty asked her mother to watch the boys and told her she was going on a coffee date with a man named Dennis. Eileen, who spoke to investigators on behalf of the family, said Patty's son, Kenny, who was 5 years old at the time, recalls begging his mother not to leave. She had promised to take him into McDonald's the next day, Eileen explained. It was their thing, but he told me that he had a gut feeling that night. He said he knew she wasn't coming home. Wow, it was that strong of a feeling. He was right. When Patty didn't return home the next morning, her mother became worried and called the police. Eileen added that Patty's date, Dennis, had also been reported missing by his family at that time. From what I understand, the police initially thought she had just run off with this Dennis guy, Eileen said, but the family knew better. Eileen explained that Patty was a stay-at-home mom, and while she did some housekeeping work. She didn't have the money or resources to run off. Most importantly, she would have never left her kids, Eileen said. From all the stories I heard throughout the years, that was always the same. She loved her boys and would have never run off. Eileen told investigators that Kenny has vivid memories of his mother taking them to the park and to the Jersey Shore, where they'd play until the sun went down. He remembers her collection of record albums and her love of music, a love passed down to him. Her disappearance wrecked them, Eileen said. It wrecked our entire family. She told investigators that the boys were raised by Patty's mother, Marie, until she died in the early 80s, just months after Patty's grandmother died. If she wasn't raising those boys, I think she would have died sooner, Eileen said. Losing her daughter and not knowing what happened to her killed her. After years of sneaking around the house late at night to listen to her family members discuss the details of Patty's disappearance, Eileen took action. While working as a full-time caregiver in New Jersey, Eileen also devoted much of her time to web sleuthing in an effort to help solve her cousin's case. With the help of Patty's sons, she obtained Patty's birth certificate and added her name to the National Missing and Unidentified Persons System, NAMIS. She added that to that CODIS also now has both her and Kenny's DNA in CODIS. I guess there's an old episode of Dateline on this case too, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. In early 2020, Eileen said that through her web sleuthing, she located a man she believes to be Dennis. Patty was going to meet the day she disappeared. She told investigators that Dennis had been living in Florida and that he refused to discuss Patty's disappearance with her family. She said she passed the information to investigators with New Jersey State Police. Attempts by Dateline by investigators to reach Dennis at the number Eileen provided were unsuccessful. Patty's disappearance is considered an open missing persons investigation that is being handled jointly by the New Jersey State Police and the Jersey City Police Department. So that's what she looked like. Apparently they did have an episode of Dateline on this too. So if you want to know more about this case, look up the episode of Dateline they had on this. I was not able to watch that, but I watched some things about this case. Now I want to say that I think the guy that she was dating before she went out on this date ran into them, or purposely ran into them, because he was prone to violence too, they said. Who knows if this lady's still alive, but she was my mom's age. My mom's still alive, so there's a possibility. Maybe she did decide to just walk away with this guy because she was afraid of her ex. That could also be a possibility. So if you have any information about Patty's case, you are asked to call New Jersey State Police, which is 609-882-2000. And here is her case number. Hope you could see that. There's her case number. And then that's the number you're supposed to call. And it is New Jersey State Police phone number. So this is what she looked like. This is how we drew her. Guys, that does it for this case. Until next time we meet, do something nice for somebody and expect nothing in return. It makes others around you feel like they want to do something nice. And they will, in turn, do something nice. I've seen it happen. Anyway, peace out, true believers.